logical, a Vulcan in disguise. The mysteries of the night are putting sparkles in his eyes. He's looking for sound reasoning, but the best that I can do is this transcendental story that I'll pass along to you. Past the falls they call Victoria, down the river named the Nile, drifts a tiny little handmade boat. It's shaped just like a smile, and steered by a magician with the knowledge that he needs to keep him on his destined course past the crocodiles and reeds. He's the admiral of the ocean, the lone eagle in the sky. He gave me my first sextant and he taught me how to fly. It's been quite a lengthy passage from the dawn of time till now. He has weathered the infernal storms in his trusty petty dhow. He has soared above colossal waves, sailed the endless sea. Sometimes he resembles you, sometimes he looks like me. I saw him through my telescope on a cloudless night in June, as he rested between voyages at his beach house on the moon. There are windows to the galaxies and hallways to the past. There are trapdoors to the future and a splintered ancient mast. There are relics from Apollo trips when the Earthmen came to play, and a hammock from a distant star out in the Milky Way. He's the admiral of the ocean, the lone eagle in the sky. He gave me my first sextant and he taught me how to fly. I saw him through my telescope on a cloudless night in June, as he rested between voyages at his beach house on the moon. Bass breaks the surface as the sunset fades away, and our journey from the sea of storms takes us home beside the bay. We go fishing in the ocean, we go traveling back in time, like the song says, teach your children to go fishing with their minds. Cameron's contemplating, I'm not sure just what he thinks. Is my dad some kind of lunatic with his stories and hijinks? Then he says, when I get old and gray, feel like I'm marooned, he will take me in his rocket ship to that beach house on the moon.